Good evening and welcome everyone to this spring concert by your Joliet American Legion Band. Our program this evening is prefaced by a quotation from Arthur O'Shaughnessy's famous ode. We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers of dreams. Yet we are the movers and shakers of the world forever, it seems. One man with a dream at pleasure shall go forth and conquer a crown, and three with a new song's measure can trample an empire down. Please enjoy this concert overture from composer Alfred Reed, The Music Makers.
Thank you.
originally scored for brass choir. This marvelous version for full band features flowing melodies and counterlines in a rich chorale-like setting. This is the very beautiful Benediction by composer John Stevens. The overture to the opera Zampa by the French composer Louis-Joseph Ferdinand Herold, premiered in Paris back in 1831. The opera was tremendously popular for a time, but then was pretty much totally forgotten, except for this very spirited overture.
Thank you.
We thank you all so much for being here tonight. I said it last year and I'll say it again. The miracle of this beautiful auditorium, its beauty, its perfect sound, where so many of us once bought cornflakes. Beyond belief. We have some business to take care of, and may I now introduce to you your Joliet American Legion Band President, Mr. Brian Heard.
Welcome to our 2019 annual spring concert and fundraiser. Last year was the first year that we had decided to take a different approach to what bands normally do to raise funds, and that is to sell tickets. And this year, last year, we said instead, well, let's just offer a free will offering. We'll have the raffle baskets and see what happens. Little did we know that this people of Joliet far exceeded our wildest dreams. And so we're doing it again this year. And we're going to be starting with passing the hat. And I believe we have some volunteers. We have hats in the front row. So if you would take those hats and pass those back and forth, those of you who wanted to provide a donation, that's the place to do it now. So if you have a hat in the front row, if you could start passing it back and forth, and we'll pick these up at the end. You may wonder what your donations and gifts are used for. And you may not realize all the expenses that a band this size has. Not only do we have rehearsal space and storage, we have musical instruments. All those instruments in the percussion sections are owned by the band. We have travel expenses to our different concerts. And one of the biggest expenses that you might not realize is that of insurance. And fortunately, we've never needed to use it, but it's a very big expense. We also are planning on going to the national contest this year in Indianapolis. Many of you already know the story, but this band was founded in 1946 by a group of returning veterans from an idea by two former members of the Joliet Township High School Band, Mr. Archie McAllister Jr. and Bill Austin. They decided, if they got back to the United States after the war, that they should form a band again. And they did in 1946, and the band was composed completely of returning veterans and those who, returning veterans who played in the Joliet Township Band. That first year, the American Legion Post asked them to go to the American Legion contest, and they went to the contest in their Army uniforms, their Navy and Army Air Corps uniforms, and they came back with a national title. Since that time, we've come back with 37 additional national titles. We also have 52 state titles and one international title. Last year, we went to the American Legion Convention and to the senior concert band competition, and we came back with a second place trophy and a first place in the parade. Therefore, we are trying to get back to Indianapolis and seeing if we can do even better this year. But enough about us. There are many costs in running a band. And as I mentioned before, one of the costs is rehearsal space. And we have been truly blessed in that the Crossroads Christian Church provides us this space free of charge. And we are truly grateful. And as part of that, Mick, would you like to come and say a few words? Mick is one of the pastors here. He's the worship pastor of the Crossroads Christian Church.
Hello, everybody. My name is Mick Murray, and I am the worship minister here at Crossroads. And I got to tell you, I can't come up here with all of you here without telling a bad joke. So, question, how many conductors does it take to screw in a light bulb? Probably just one, but who's watching them anyway? No. We all know that you know, the conductor is vital to the band, and the band here has put in so many hours of work, both individually and as a collective, and you can tell just by how great they sound, how well they play together, and it is our privilege to be hosting them, and I hope that you enjoy your evening here as well. I do want to let you know, if you are looking for a place to worship on Easter, I want to invite you. We're going to be in this room next weekend on Easter Sunday at 8:45. 10 and 11:30, and so I want to invite you to that as well. But it is our honor to host the Joliet Legion Band on a weekly basis for the rehearsals and especially for the spring concert. This is our second year able to do this. So just on behalf of Crossroads, thank you so much for being here today to enjoy the band with us.
Thank you, Mick. And I would be a little remiss if I didn't mention the fact that we are thrilled to have Mike Fisk conducting us after some unfortunate circumstances this year, and he's doing a fantastic job. And now, Steve, will you come up and tell us what we're playing next?
I so wish that my daughter Natalie were here with us tonight. She's home from college, but at Wheaton North High School to see their musical, but we are about to talk about one of her all-time favorite shows. Based on a classic novel by Victor Hugo, Les Mis opened in Paris in 1980, and 5 years later in London, where it became the longest running musical in West End history. This masterful medley arranged by Warren Barker includes At the End of the Day, I Dreamed a Dream, Master of the House, On My Own, and Do You Hear the People Sing? Our director emeritus Tom Drake conducts. The Dam Busters. Who you gonna call? Never mind. This movie came out 29 years before that one did. The Dam Busters is the theme to the popular 1955 film of the same name. Some of the material in this march is reportedly from Eric Coates' 8th Army March, which was composed during World War II. Now, during the war, a special RAF unit was assigned the task of blowing up the Ruhr power dams. And that unit was indeed labeled the Dam Busters. The success of its daring operations is the story told in that 1955 movie.
Thank you.
As awesome as this program has been, I am happy to report we've only just begun. We are now taking about a 20-minute intermission. Now remember, this is your final chance to put in your bids and all those wonderful items out there. And we thank all the donors from the bottom of our hearts. So check everything out, and we'll see you back here in just a bit. Welcome back. One of 12 marches that...
Are we on?
One of 12 marches, there we are, that John Philip Sousa composed for various expositions or fairs included The Pathfinder of Panama. It was dedicated to the Panama Canal and the Panama Pacific Exposition held in San Francisco in the year 1915. Here to open the second half of our concert is the Pathfinder of Panama March.
Thank you.
Associate Director Jillian Langerstrom now comes to the podium to conduct the band in Flourish for Wind Band by Ralph Vaughn Williams. It opens with a simple brass fanfare, and then this gives way to a lyrical melody before the fanfare then returns at the end of the piece. Overture for Winds, written in 1959, is a model example of Carter's inevitable expertise in marrying quick, intricate melodies with poetic lyrical phrases that are spread throughout the piece. Overture for Winds is one of Carter's most renowned pieces in the wind band literature.
Thank you.
We are pleased to welcome to the podium Jim Cruz, Associate Director, to conduct the medley from Miss Saigon. Arranger Warren Barker has captured the musical's infectious theatrical style with an impressive medley for the band, which includes The Heat Is On in Saigon, Sun and Moon, The Morning of the Dragon, The Last Night of the World, The American Dream, and I Still Believe.
Thank you. Thank you.
Luigi Denza, an Italian who later taught at the Royal Academy of Music in London, composed thousands of popular songs. And with over 1 million copies sold after the first year of publication, Funiculi Funicula is by far the most popular, famously recorded by the one and only Luciano Pavarotti and the three tenors. This delightful arrangement by Alfred Reed gives every section of the band a chance to shine.
I just want to take a brief moment to thank the members of the band for all of their hard work in getting this concert ready. It's been an absolutely delightful experience for me to come in and work with them and direct the group. It's an amazing group of people. And so I thought it was only fitting that we included that little bit of the poem at the beginning of the concert, because these guys truly are movers and shakers, and I've had a great time with them. And the gals are too, so I don't want to leave them out. I want to just thank Brian Hurt and the board for asking me to do this, and what a fun time it is for me to come on Tuesday nights and spend some time with these folks. There's a couple of other people here that I want to thank. I was sitting out here listening to the band and getting a little bit nostalgic, because there are people in the band that were students of mine, and there are people in the band that were classmates of mine, and there are people in the band that were names that I heard about when I was a kid and looked up to. And so what an experience. I want to thank my wife Nancy for being here today, and a real special thing for me is that two of my mentors, the two of the people that have meant the most to me in my musical life, took the time to come and hear the concert today, and that's Jerry Lewis and Ted Liga. And so thanks you guys for being here too, okay? I hope you've had as much fun as I have this afternoon. We're not quite done yet. You're gonna love this Alfred Reed Funiculi Funicula.
You know, it's funny, Mike and I were talking before the show tonight, and he said, when we do Funiculi Funicula, you're going to recognize it so much. Well, you bet I did from my childhood. Part of that melody, anybody remember the opera singing Reardon singing that in the neighborhood of Make Believe on Mr. Rogers? Yeah. Or the melody was also used for an Acne product commercial on WLS radio, okay? Me as a kid thinking I'm going to go into radio. Oh, yeah, I remember that. Stridex BP, by the way. Mike, you were right. I recognized every note. Hey, we thank you for your attendance this evening. So special. We hope you've enjoyed this concert of your Joliet American Legion Band. And as Mike was saying a moment ago, let's emphasize once again, the name Tom Drake is synonymous with our closing selection. Please welcome once again our Director Emeritus to the podium as your Joliet American Legion Band presents the Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you all for coming. God bless and happy Easter. And remember, this concert of the Julian American Legion Band will be shown on cable channel 6 the week of the 25th. Many times you'll have a chance to see and hear it all again. Thank you.